Welcome to another Power BI tutorial. Today, we will connect Power BI Desktop to an online SQL Server database. The server address, username, and password are placed in the description below for you. Let's dive into the tutorial. To connect to the SQL Server, click on the SQL Server button on the Home tab. Now enter the server name and the name of the database you want to connect to. Select Import as Data Connectivity Mode and press OK. Now you need to enter the username and password to connect to the database. Since we are going to connect to an online SQL Server, we will use the Database tab. Any username and password entered here will be permanently stored on this computer. To remove these passwords, you will have to remove the data sources from Query Editor. Enter the username and password and press Connect to connect to the online SQL Server database. Our server does not support an encrypted connection, and the information is not sensitive as well, therefore we will press OK. On the Navigator window, you can select the tables you want to import. Select all the tables you want to import, and then press Load to load them in your Power BI application. Once loaded, all the tables and their fields will appear in the Data tab, which can be used to create Power BI visuals. The database that we are using is a relational database. In the model view, we need to connect all these tables by creating relationships between them using IDs. First, we will arrange these tables for better visibility and management. Sometimes, Power BI creates relationships on its own. Remove all links created automatically by Power BI. We will link departments table to the units table using the department ID. Then we will connect designations table to the employees table using designation ID. We will use the education ID to connect the education table. We will connect the units table to the employees table as well. Press OK to create a many-to-many relationship. To assign basic salaries to employees, we will connect the salary table to the employees table using the designation ID. As usual, let's start by creating a title for our dashboard using the text box visual. From the departments table, add the title field to the dashboard. Now, convert this visual into a pie chart. Add first name from employees table to the values field of pie chart. Rename the legend to departments and values field to number of employees, to display number of employees by departments. Now place the pie chart in the visual in an appropriate place. To display number of employees by designation, we will duplicate the existing pie chart. We will remove the departments field from the legend area and replace it with the title field from the designations table. We can use filters to hide senior management and show employees only. Next, we will display number of employees by education, by duplicating an existing chart. We will replace the designations field in legend area, with the description field from education table. Rename the designation field to education, to display number of employees by education. Here we want to display all employees, including the senior management. To display number of employees by location, we will use a map visual. Add the address field from employees table to the location area. And the first name field to the bubble size area as count. Rename the count of first name field to number of employees. And the address field to location. Add a visual to display number of employees by gender. Add gender field from employees table to the y-axis. And first name field to the x-axis as count. Rename the x-axis to gender and y-axis to number of employees. Change the visual type to a pie chart. Finally, we will add a scatter chart to display number of employees by their salary. We will add the basic salary field from salary table to the y-axis of the scatter chart, and the first name field to the x-axis, as count. Rename the x-axis field to number of employees and y-axis field to basic salary. And this is it. We have successfully imported data from an online SQL server, created a relational database, and designed a visualization using that database. We hope you liked our tutorial. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.